The reason why huge automakers like Toyota have dominated the market for so long is not just because they offer vehicles for every need and taste, but also that their engines are among the best. Their new hydrogen fuel cell engine is focused on efficiency and carbon neutrality, two characteristics that complete. Since the 1930s, Toyota has produced engines for its own and other manufacturers' vehicles. But today, Toyota engines are found in a variety of vehicles, including compact cars, trucks, and SUVs. In 2015, Toyota announced the Environmental Challenge 2050, which aims to reduce the CO2 activity for the entire vehicle life cycle, from production to vehicle usage and recycling. They believe that in order to achieve these objectives, the use of environmentally friendly automobiles must be widespread and contribute to CO2 reduction. To further their route, Toyota is making investments in the creation of electric vehicles, hydrogen fuel cells, and renewable energy sources. In this video, we'll discuss what this technology means for the auto industry and car owners, as well as its viability and limitations. Toyota recently introduced a new engine that runs entirely on hydrogen and emits water vapor instead of carbon dioxide, offering a more environmentally friendly and sustainable alternative to fossil fuels. Keep reading. One characteristic that distinguishes Toyota from other automakers is its dedication to innovation and technology. Toyota was one of the first businesses to market hybrid automobiles, and it continues to be a pioneer in the development of hybrid and electric vehicles. Their hybrid system powers the car with both an electric motor and a gasoline engine, which increases fuel efficiency and lowers emissions. For instance, the Toyota Prius is one of the most well-known hybrid cars on the market and has become synonymous with hybrid technology. The Japanese automaker places a high priority on safety, and many of its models have received top safety ratings from agencies like the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration. Toyota's focus on engine research and development has contributed to the company's impressive performance, which attracts buyers. The company's journey towards producing top-performing engines began in 1934 with the production of the Type N engine, and despite initial challenges with the water jacket's core, Toyota completed its first prototype engine in September of 1934. The engine could only cast crankshafts, camshafts, valves, plugs, and electrical components were made in-house, but when the prototype was installed in a Chevrolet truck, the engine could only produce 48 to 49 horsepower. However, after redesigning the cylinder head, the engine produced 65 horsepower, outperforming the Chevrolet. From that point on, Toyota never looked back. In 1992, the Japanese company began researching fuel efficiency. The 2021 Toyota Mirai took FCEV technology to the next level and combined it with innovative packaging and better aerodynamic efficiency. It increased the driving experience. It also featured a fuel cell system with an output power density of 3 kilowatts per liter, delivering an output power of more than 100 kilowatts, and used Toyota's proprietary lightweight fuel cell stack and 270 megapascals high-pressure hydrogen tanks placed beneath the specially designed body. A fuel cell engine is a device that electrolyzes chemical energy from a fuel, such as hydrogen as in the case of Toyota, to create electricity, which can then be used to drive an electric motor that can move a car or other machinery. Protons can pass through the electrolyte to the cathode, while the electrons are forced to take an external circuit, creating an electrical current at the cathode where oxygen from the air is supplied and reacts with the protons and electrons to produce an electrical current. Fuel cells typically use hydrogen as their fuel source. A catalyst causes the hydrogen molecules to split into protons and electrons at the anode. Due to their high energy density, which allows them to store a lot of energy in a small amount of space, fuel cells are ideal for use in vehicles because they can power the electric motor while occupying less space than conventional internal combustion engines. One of their main advantages is that they are highly efficient and produce little to no pollution, as the only byproducts are water and heat. The Mirai didn't perform as well as expected for a variety of reasons, so Toyota had to come up with a new way to use hydrogen to power their engines. This time, it would be used as fuel in a combustion engine rather than a fuel cell, since the fuel cell uses hydrogen as an electrochemical substance rather than a combustible fuel. The 1.6-liter turbocharged three-cylinder previously found in the GR Yaris and the GR Corolla gave birth to the hydrogen internal combustion engine, a modified version of the conventional gasoline-powered internal combustion engine. In order to create a new prototype hydrogen internal combustion engine car called the Corolla Cross H2 concept, Toyota modified the 1.6-liter turbocharged three-cylinder and added a heavy-duty fuel tank to contain the hydrogen under high pressure. This means that it operates differently from other internal combustion engines because, for example, thick armored fuel tanks are used for holding the hydrogen technology because hydrogen is a highly flammable gas. Hardened steel is also added to the car's powerplant. The engine works by combining hydrogen gas with oxygen in the combustion chamber, where it is ignited by a spark plug just like a conventional gasoline engine, and all of these modifications are intended to prevent hazards that could arise from the flammable nature of hydrogen. Stronger connecting rods, valves, valve seats, and fuel injectors that are designed for gas rather than liquid are also included. Toyota and Yamaha Motor have partnered to create a hydrogen-fueled V8 engine that will have 455 horsepower and 398 pound-feet of torque. The 8-into-1 top-mounted exhaust manifold on the V8 engine contributes to the powerplant's distinctive high-frequency sound. The fact that a hydrogen combustion engine emits no harmful pollutants, such as carbon dioxide and nitrogen oxides, as opposed to a conventional gasoline engine, is one of its key advantages over the latter. Hydrogen has a higher energy density than gasoline, so hydrogen combustion engines can convert more of the fuel's energy into usable power. Additionally, hydrogen combustion engines can be designed to have a higher C efficiency. Since water vapor is the only byproduct of the combustion process, hydrogen combustion engines are an appealing option for reducing emissions in the transportation sector. Because hydrogen, unlike gasoline, needs to be stored in high-pressure tanks and distributed through a specialized fueling infrastructure that is currently insufficient, it is challenging for hydrogen-powered vehicles to be widely adopted. Furthermore, hydrogen fuel is an alternative to conventional fossil fuels and is interchangeable. However, the cost of producing hydrogen fuel is another issue. Currently, the majority of hydrogen is made from natural gas, which is a fossil fuel. Research is being done to develop more sustainable hydrogen production methods, such as using renewable electricity to power the electrolysis of water to produce hydrogen. The hydrogen-powered engine is not completely the Toyota concept has been around for a while, but BMW helped make it one of the most popular in the early 2000s. As a form of experiment to show the public that hydrogen can be used on passenger cars, the BMW 7 Series E65 featured a model that operated on hydrogen instead of gasoline or diesel. This variant was built in 100 units. The Hydrogen 7 had two tanks, one for hydrogen fuel and the other for gasoline. The hydrogen fuel was kept in a sizable, nearly 170-liter bi-layered, highly insulated tank. Hydrogen is a liquid that, at 700 bars of pressure, offers 75% more energy per volume as a fuel than compressed gas. High vacuum was applied to the insulation of the tank to minimize heat transmission to the hydrogen, while BMW claimed zero emissions. The EPA disagreed, arguing that because the engine utilized in the prototypes was still an internal combustion engine unit and used lubrication, it was not recognized as an emission-free vehicle and that minute oil particles may enter the combustion chamber. BMW completely abandoned its effort because it was so upset with how the EPA saw it as we hurried towards net-zero fuel cell technology. Engineers may be able to permanently fix the issues that plague hydrogen combustion engines given how expensive the overall process is. Do you think Toyota's hydrogen combustion engines are worth it? Vehicles will become more popular, and we'll see these reoccurring patterns emerge over time. Leave a comment and let us know what you think.